إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. All praise be to Allah, the King of the world, the Master of the Day of Judgment. I bear witness no one is worthy of worship but Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is the last and greatest messenger of Allah, was sent to mankind to bring them out of the darkness of this world to the light of this world and the hereafter, and from the injustices of religions to the justice of Islam. قال تعالى إن الدين عند الله الإسلام. عباد الله، he صلى الله عليه وسلم was sent to bring the people out of the darkness of this dunya to the light of this dunya and the hereafter, and this bothers me a lot. Feel someone in your face. فما بال المسلمون يعيشون في ظلمة. If he صلى الله عليه وسلم was sent to bring the people out of the darkness to the light, how come the Muslims live in darkness 1500 years later? Why أذلنا الله لأذل خلقه؟ Why he سبحانه وتعالى humiliated us to the most humiliated people ever to live, according to the book of Allah. من لعنهم الله. Why we are so weak? Why we are so backward? Why we are so oppressed? You have a player, a basketball player, posting a video about a group of people. The world, the dunya, تقوم ولا تقعد, becomes the issue of the globe, becomes the most pressing issue in the states. Forget about housing problems, forget about financial problems, forget about gas problems, forget about people being homeless, forget about racism, forget about all that. This becomes the issue of the globe. But Muslims are being slaughtered day and night. Nobody talks about them. You know what? We are the problem. We are almost 2 billion people, and yet we are looking for people to cry on our behalf. We can't even cry for ourselves. We know this dark conditions we live in. We know the dire situation we live in. Only an ignorant, negligent, out of this world person can claim otherwise. Only someone who doesn't want to hit reality. Only someone who doesn't want to do anything. Only someone who doesn't even want to make an effort. Only someone who doesn't even want to bother with feelings will convince himself that everything is okay. Or someone whose dreams do not and his goals and his mission in life does not pass the place of his feet. All he thinks about, eating, drinking, getting a degree, getting married, having a house, having a car, having children, enjoying my time, and that's it. What's the difference between you and anybody else, yet you have the Book of Allah? You have the Deen of Allah. You have the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ibad Allah, might the topic today be redundant, but we, or I should say, I am embarrassed to talk about it, but it must be talked about all the time. Very embarrassing question, yet very important and elegant. ماذا قدمت لدين الله? What have you offered and what have you done for the deen of Allah? أنت مسلم. You and me claim we're Muslims all day long. The question now, what have we done for the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal? Because you have to live, you are on a mission. Allah Azza wa Jal, when He created us, He subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us down a book. That book has a verse in it that we all know it. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ I only created you to worship me. Now the question becomes, how much of my schedule to fulfill this purpose? Sounds very simple question. But when we hit reality, and when we evaluate ourselves, for the most part, it's embarrassing. Don't you agree? We got caught with everything else except the purpose. We got busy with everything else except the purpose. We think about everything else except why Allah Azza wa Jal put me in this world. It sounds so simple and so basic and rudimentary. يعني, any Muslim knows that. Like if it's that simple, where are we from there? Where are we from there? So I repeat the question, and I hope each one of us be honest with himself. What have you offered to the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal? And do not try to convince me that anyone in this room or in this masjid or anywhere has nothing to offer. So first, we have to accept the fact and acknowledge that we are slaves to Allah Azza wa Jalla. I will share with you some events to show you that it doesn't take much for you to be a very active contributor to the deen and to the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And fi ujala, very quickly, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu, he becomes Muslim. How much did he spend learning? How many books did he read? How many lectures he listened to? How many khutbas he sat in before he went out and he came back to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with 5 of the 10 that were giving al-mubashirin bil-jannah. 5 of the 10 that the Prophet ﷺ in a specific hadith said and promised them paradise, 5 of the 10, Abu Bakr brought them, they became Muslim in the hands of Abu Bakr. Uthman, Sa'd, Talha, Abd al-Rahman, and Zubayr. 5. He didn't waste any time. He didn't say, I need to learn fiqh first, and usul al-fiqh, and seerah, and da'wah, and that. Huh? Before I go out and make da'wah, I have to learn the adab and the etiquette of da'wah. La. From the very first moment, he felt the obligation and the duty and the responsibility to go out and do something for this. Tufail ibn Amr al-Dawsi, radiyallahu anhu, comes to Mecca, and that's before Hijrah, comes to Mecca, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam starring in the, with the deen, and he's a prophet. So the the elite of Quraysh come to him and said, listen, this guy is dangerous. والحمد لله الذي أسمعنا فينا ما قيل في النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال لك هذا dangerous. هذا يفرق بين الأب وأبوه. بين الأب وابنه. This guy, don't talk to him, he's dangerous. Muhammad, dangerous, extremist. Fanatic. He divides between a father and a son. He comes with new prayers. He calls for something weird. He calls sunnah. Time doesn't repeat itself. Sounds like it's just the names change, but it's the same accusations, right? So don't listen to him. Stay away from him. هذا الطفال بن عم avoided him for a while. Then he saw him praying next to the Kaaba. He said, "Thakilatka ummuk ya Tufail." And he said, "What's wrong with you?" He's talking to himself. "What's wrong with you? إنك رجل لبيب شاعر أديب. أنت, you're a very smart person. You're very intelligent." He's talking to himself again. "You're a poet. What is it you're scared to listen to this guy? Well, you will not be able to differentiate between if what he says is what they claim and it's gibberish or it's truth. Listen to him." قال فتتبعته حتى خرج من الكعبة. So I followed him until he left the Kaaba. And I went and I said, "Give me what you have." قال فبكلمات بسيطة. Very small words. He صلى الله عليه وسلم explained to him what he's inviting for. قال والله إن هذا الحسن. He said, "By Allah, this sounds good." قال ابسط يدك أبايعك. He said, he told the Prophet ﷺ, "Stretch out your hand, let me give you shahada." He took the shahada. It's not there, the point I want you to get. From that moment, he said, "Ya Rasulullah, give me the permission to go back to Daws, Daws way, fil Yemen. Go back to my people so I can invite them to La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah." On the moment. So the Prophet ﷺ gave him the permission. He went, he invited them, they rejected. He came back, قال يا رسول الله هلك الدوس ادعو الله أن يهلكه. He said, "Ya Rasulullah, those people don't want good for themselves. They don't know what's best for them. Make dua against them for Allah to destroy them." فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم رفع يديه وقال اللهم اهدي دوسا واتي به. Oh Allah, guide Daws and bring them to Daws, the tribe. So he goes back at Tufail bin Amr. He finds, he invites them again. They all embrace Islam. And he comes with them to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And one of them is Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. هذا Abu Huraira in the book of هذا راوية الإسلام. The one who narrates the most from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam hadith is Abu Huraira. عبد الرحمن بن صخر الدوسي. He comes in the book of Tufail bin Amr. He didn't say, "Let me hang out with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let me enjoy my time here in Mecca. Let me learn more and then I go make la." Right away. Right away. How long we've been in Islam? How long each one of us been Muslim? How many people, you changed their hearts by the permission of Allah and became Muslim? How many people? How many people you taught to be on the right path? Muslims that you have power to change their hearts and you didn't bother. One of the Sahaba that many people don't know named Nu'aym ibn Mas'ud. His story is interesting. As you know, in the Battle of Al-Khandaq Al-Ahzab, when the 10,000 disbelievers came and surrounded Al-Madinah from Quraysh and Ghatafan, and then at the same time, Bani Qurayza, again, they're known for the betrayed their treaty with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they had alliance with Quraysh and with Ghatafan, the kuffar, so they can attack the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Sahaba at the same time. Allah azza wa jal will always get a way for this ummah to get after. Allah, ya akhwan, you read in history prior to Islam, and you see some empires where rose and thrived, and then they completely disappear. There is no mentioning of them whatsoever, including the Jews, including Hebrew. You know the language Hebrew? Maymun al-Andalusi, one of the scholars of the Yahud in Al-Andalus, under the Islamic Khilafah. You know Hebrew was lost. They could not figure it out how to understand Hebrew. Do you know these Jews, the language they speak, the grammar of it is from the Arabic grammar. From the Arabic grammars. He came and he took the Torah and he put it together and he started plugging words after words using the Arabic grammar until he was able to reconstruct the Hebrew language that they speak today. These people, their grammar from Arab, and they're so devastated their children have to put the shoes of Kyrie Irving because he talked bad about them. So devastated. And the kids in Malaysia and Indonesia and Philippines and Bangladesh who make these shoes for pennies, those have, they're not important. And the children of Palestine who get, killed thousands of them so far, those have no merit, right? And the children of Iraq and Afghanistan and Yemen have no merit. Amma Jewish children in New York and New Jersey are so devastated, they're not going to wear their Nike shoes, which I don't know how much it cost. And I'm surprised they even paid for it. You understand the hypocrisy in the world we live in? And then we expect justice from people like that. We expect justice from a system like that. We expect justice from people who think like that. هذا نعيم بن مسعود. In the midst of all this, and the kuffar, and the Jews, and the munafiqeen inside, ما وعدنا الله ورسوله إلا غرورا. They're all plotting against Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. هذا نعيم بن مسعود on the side of غطفان. He's غطفان. With the kuffar, Allah guides his heart. He comes to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in secret. He said, يا رسول الله, ابسط إلي يديك أبايم. He said, يا رسول الله, I want to give shahad. I am convinced that your deen is the truth. You think there was da'wah at that time? It was frightening. It was so scary at that time. 10,000, never heard of in Arabia. 10,000 surrounding in Medina. And you have the hypocrites inside. And you have the Jews on the other side. Hey, who brought this, this iman to his heart at that moment? And you have to think. He said, Ya Rasulallah, murni. فَوَاللَّهِ مَا تَأْمُرُنِي بِشَيْءٍ إِلَّا قَوِيٍ. He said, Ya Rasulallah, order me to do anything. Nothing you order me to do, but I will do. Nobody knows I became Muslim. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ رَجُلٌ إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ فِينَا رَجُلٌ وَاحِدٌ. You're only one man. لَكِنْ خَذِّلِ الْقَوْمَ عَنْهُ. He said, discourage them to get away from us. وَالْحَرْبُ خَدْعَةٌ. كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, خدعة 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 ثلاثية. لأنها تأتي أنت الخدعة بدك تجيبها من أي مكان. So هذا نعيم بن مسعود. What did he do? He goes to the Jews, to Bani Qurayza. He said, listen, you know our relationship and we're friends. I have to warn you. أنت now, you break your deal with Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, and this Quraysh and Ghatafan, they came from Mecca. They can go back to where they came from and they will leave you alone and Muhammad will slaughter you. They said, okay, what do you think we should do? He said, you should ask them to send you 70 men of their best as a rahan. 70 men as a guarantee that they will not leave, but 70 of their best. You keep them with you. And when the fight comes, you all fight. They said, what a good idea. He goes to Quraysh. He tells them, listen, هذول يهود قوم غدر. And you know, we're together. And these Jews, they always break their promise. They're breaking their promise now to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. فبي careful. Because they regret what they did. and they're going to ask you for 70 men as a guarantee, but they want to turn them to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to kill them so they can show him that they're regretful. Then he goes to Ghatafan and tells them the same thing. So in no time, a messenger comes from the side of Bani Qurayza to tell Quraysh or Abu Sufyan, we want 70 men from you. قالت كذبت يهود وصدق نعيم. They said, oh, Nu'aym was telling us the truth. And these Jews are liars. So when they refused, the Jews said, صدق نعيم وكذب أبو سفيان. And that was the reason for this alliance to break. And you know the rest of the story. Nu'aym ibn Mas'ud, from the moment he became Muslim, he said, Ya Rasul Allah, what can I do? طبعا حيطلع لك واحد مغفل يقول لك, oh, the Muslim shouldn't lie. We have those. Oh, how can Sahabi lie? Huh? Muslim shouldn't lie. Yeah? So we're going to sit, because this is what's happening, we're going to sit, وسلمية وسلمية, we're peaceful, we're peaceful. We have someone pointing her, a bazooka at us, and we're carrying her غصن الغصن إيش غصن الزيتون. يا عمي, doesn't work like that. Who's attacking you, you attack back. فمن اعتدى عليكم فاعتدوا عليه بمثل ما اعتدى عليكم. أما this weakness, so they plot against us, and we want to show them that we're merciful, that we are peaceful, we are tolerant, we are this. These things are given to those who deserve it. These things giving to someone who doesn't deserve it is foolishness. Wallahi, there will be no Islam if this was the mentality of your Prophet. This against logic. Against logic. And if it tawheed, and if la ilaha illallah was your priority and the most important thing, then you won't be allowing those who say God has a son, or God was crucified, or God did, to walk, stand on the minbar of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and behind the mic of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But it's not priority, as much as you want to say. Our children are lost. Our children don't know who they are. They have no identity. They are confused. They hear something in the masjid, and they hear something in the school, and they hear something at home, and the dad says something different than the mom, and then we are worried about what? Interfaith. Ya ammi. We think Dabka and Al-Hatta and Al-Argila are going to bring Palestine back. Oh, this is Muqawama. Dabka and Argila. Hada went out and worked from the first moment for his deen. Now you might say, well, we are all sinners. These people were good. Abu Mihjan, he was addicted to alcohol, to al-khamr. And the day of Al-Qadisiyah, he was brought to the general of the Muslim army, Sa'd bin Abi Waqqas, because he was drunk. So he ordered for him to be lashed, to be whipped, and to be chained. We don't want someone like that in the army. When the battle started, and it's difficult on the Muslims, and these Persians have a lot of new skills and elephants and all that, Abu Mihjan started, Al-Ghira. And the love for the deen, that tawheed stopped boiling in his heart. I want to do something, but I'm chained. So he called on Salma, the wife of Sa'd. And Sa'd was sick, so he was leading the battle from Arish, from far. He said, let me go, free me, and give me the horse and the weapon of Sa'd. And I promise you, if I survive, I will come back and put myself. He goes out, and he fights, and he flips the situation, the favorite becomes the Muslims because of one man who felt the responsibility to do something for his deen and for his people. And Sa'd, watching the battlefield, he said, wallahi, if I did not know that Abu Mihjan in the chains, I would say that's Abu Mihjan. And I would say that horse is al-Balqa, my horse. So his wife tells him, that's your horse and that's Abu Mihjan. That's what we want. We want hearts boiling for the deen of Allah, just like it boils for the Miami Dolphins. Are we serious? We are Ummat Muhammad. Until you understand, appreciate, take a second to appreciate that you are from the Ummah of a man named Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ana Sayyidu Waladi'ah. انت كان يو اندرستاند ان اون ذا اذر هاند يو هاف سم مسلم وومن وذ سم كونفولوتد اندرستاندينج واي دونت نو وات دين ذي فولوين ذي سي ذير مسلمز او اندرو تيت بيكام مسلم ام ليفينج اسلام الله معك الله ياخذك قال ام ليفينج اسلام A man becomes Muslim, she's gonna leave Islam. Because a man who's anti-feminist leaves Islam. Feminism has nothing to do with our deen. Put in your head, feminism is destroying these societies. They are destroying themselves internally. We don't have to do any work. And then you have these Muslim women who wants to act like they know Islam the best. They destroyed homes. This mentality leads to divorce and children being like living like orphans when both parents are alive. So my advice to the brothers, make sure when you go to get married, ask her what she thinks about the conversion of Andrew Tate. Then that will give you a hint. Should I marry her or not today? Unfortunately, that will tell you where she stands. That's just an example of the society we live in. We have our children with atheism inflicted, homosexuality, as they call it. A lot of problems. We need to focus on that. And then when we want to do something good, we have to commit sins. That will not work. We want to bring people to the Muslim. We get them mixed together. Young men with young women, God knows, exchanging numbers, relationship, haram. And then we think, alhamdulillah, we're bringing the community together. Get out of your dream. We either do it right or we walk in the shade of those who are doing it right. Amma, sitting back is not an option. It's not an option. قُلُوا قَوْلِي هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ يَا جَمَعَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ Brothers, come forward a little bit. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله وصلي وسلم على خير هذا المبعوث رحمة للعباد محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. Very good. The future is for Islam. A promise from Allah and a promise from Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم who does not speak out of his own caprice or out of his own desires or out of his own hour. The question you should ask, the next question you should ask yourself, huh? Do I want to be part of that? That's what you need to think about. This Islam, wallahi, tallahi, billahi, will rise. Whether the world likes it or they don't like it, will rise. What I was talking about history, that I did not complete the idea, is nations and civilizations that you thought will never vanish. That's it, they're here forever. Completely disappeared. Completely disappeared. And Islam still stands. Where is Alexander the Great? Where is it? Huh? Where is Athens? Huh? Where is the Roman Empire? Will Islam still stand? Where is Persia? Islam is still standing. Pride yourself that you're Muslim. Understand it's the greatest ni'mah from Allah. He made you Muslim. Don't get caught with anything out there. Yeah, you spend 8 years, 10 years to get a degree and then you get in a car after graduation and you die in a car accident. كل من عليها فان. Everything will vanish. Attach your heart to Allah Azza wa Jal and to the deen of Allah. Nobody is telling you, don't do all that. Go study, or get degrees, or become rich, or make money in a halal way. That's another story. But do all that. Strive, prosper, thrive. But always remember you're a slave to Allah Azza wa Jal. And what you do needs to be in alignment with what Allah Azza wa Jal has drawn for you. Al-halal bayin wal-haram bayin. Halal is clear wal-haram clear. Allahumma izzal Islam wal-Muslimin.